Hello, in this video we will see how to create a land design terrain in Grasshopper, and we will use this existing surface in Rhino for that. The land terrain can be created either from points or from curves, so we will need to obtain either the curves or points on the surface to use them as input data for the terrain. So first of all, I will reference this surface using the surface param. I do right click to link it, and I will use a divide surface component. I can find it under surface util divide surface to place points over the surface. So under the params numeric slider, I will define this as an integer number from 1 to, let's say, 50 point count, and have one for the U direction of the surface and another for the B direction. Now, if I take a look at the list of points that come out from this component, I can see that they are distributed in different groups. If I use this list, this current list, to create a terrain, a different terrain will be created by each group of those points, and I don't want that. So what I need to do is to flatten this list. I do right click, select flatten option, and convert this list of points in one single group. Now, I can place a lands terrain component, connect the list of points, and a terrain with the default options is created. If I want to edit more detail on this terrain, I need to place a terrain options component. We can use a numeric slider that goes from 0.5 to, let's say, 2 meters. For the X and Y size of the cell of the resulting terrain mesh, to have control over the precision, the accuracy of the terrain geometry. There are other details that they can add to the terrain. They are the same as those that are available for the terrain object. And since I have this component linked with the original surface, if I modify the control points of this surface, of course, the terrain will be updated. Now, if I bake this component, go to solution, bake selected, I get as a result a terrain object. I will hide the surface, select this terrain object, and we can see here all the terrain features. So we can hide the control points or show it in 2D and 3D at the same time.